Hello, happy Easter, everybody. Even though this might be after Easter, I hope you had a good one. Today is Easter, what is today? Saturday. Easter Saturday, I guess, or tomorrow's Easter Sunday. As you saw from the video previously, or before this, that we went lionfish hunting yesterday, which is an invasive venomous fish that's down here that's not supposed to be here. And one of the great way things we like to do with the fish is when we get it, we love to make ceviche out of it. And that's one of the better ways to eat it. You can cook it any other way you cook normal fish as well. Just to save you guys all the boring stuff about how to cut it and prep it all, basically what we do is we cut all the fish up into small little pieces, and then we'll squeeze lime juice into it, and then make sure we just cover the fish. Generally leave it for about 1 hour in the fridge, and I let it cool off again. And then I'm ready to add the different stuff that we add to it. And everyone is different, depends what you like and what you don't. For example here, we have orange peppers, red peppers, and green peppers. We have tomatoes and onions. We have obviously some celery and some, what's this called again?
Cilantro.
Cilantro, thank you. Depends. My wife loves it really spicy, but my kids not so much, so I have some serranos and some jalapenos here, which we'll just actually cut them up and make them into a salsa for when we actually have the ceviche. And as well with the avocados, we don't want to add the avocados right now because they'll go off by the time we're ready to eat this. So what I'm going to do right now is add the rest of the ingredients into this, and then we'll let the ceviche sit for another few hours in the fridge, and then we're good to eat. Okay? So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to add just some salt, some sea salt into it. Also some pepper. Oops. There you go. And also I like to add just a little bit of olive oil in there as well. Maybe about a tablespoon or so. Okay. I don't know. I just kind of ad-lib it as I go. Okay. Now we're going to add the onions and the tomatoes. And I'm not sure. We probably cut too many, but we'll see. And I'm also going to add the peppers and stuff right now as well. I'll leave a little bit there just in case. And then here's some celery we're going to add. And then last but not least, we're going to add the cilantro. Okay? Once we've done all that, we're going to just mix it all up. And then we'll see where we're at. I may have to add some more lime juice, as we want all the stuff to be completely covered with lime juice when we're letting it soak in the fridge for the next little next couple hours. So it's looking pretty good. I don't really think we need to add much more into there. Just we're gonna have to add some more lime juice, as obviously it's not quite covering all of everything quite now. So we're just gonna add some more lime juice. And once we have enough lime juice in there, all we're going to do is just put it back in the fridge and let it cook. The citric acid in the lime juice actually helps to cook the fish. You can also add, if you like, you can add limes, you can add lemons, or if you want to add a little bit of orange as well to it, which adds a nice flavor to it as well. Just really depends on your taste on how you'd like to make it. One more second here. I think that we'll be good with limes after this. Avocado when we're ready to eat this, and we always eat these with tortilla chips, which actually is very good right now. We will very fresh fish, very good. Let me know if you have any comments, suggestions. Thanks very much.